What's up, guys? My name is Frederick. If you're new to this channel, welcome to my channel and welcome to my vlog. Let's weigh in first. I don't know if you can see, so let's move this weighing scale here. Something 80 officially. So 80. This is my first. Thank you for that wonderful light. Anyway, let's turn it first. Tidy, we have to tidy things. I don't like messy things. Wait. It's nice. Don't mind the fan, it's just the fan. I'm not using an air condition. I'm not. We're saving energy and money. So anyway, story time, guys. Where are we at? So, yeah, the official weight now is 80 something kilograms. I'm not sure how much is it in pounds. Story time. Let's go back to that. First of all, I'm not promoting anything like a diet or something or whatever diet it was supposed to be. Anyway, to start with, what triggers or what made me decide to do a diet? By the way, I'm not conscious or anything, and I'm not promoting any kind or form of diet, whatever it is, because you really have to accept. For one, you have to be thankful, I think, for if you come to think of it, why you should be thankful? Because we should be thankful that we can eat 3 times a day. We're in the Philippines, we eat 3 times a day, so that's the most important meal of the day. 3 times a day, one in the morning, one in the lunch, and one dinner. So, and then here we go, the odds. So, and for all we know, there are a lot of people, children, families, who can't eat even a decent meal, one decent meal a day. So yeah, the odds. So you have to love yourself, thankful that you can eat 3 times. Or growing up, we have nothing, we have not that much, so I am thankful for that I can eat a decent meal 3 times a day. Anyway, what triggers me, going back to the subject, what triggers me to do the dieting? At first, I didn't know that it was a keto or ketogenic diet, that's they're saying. I'm not religiously following the ketogenic diet. If you know what the ketogenic diet is, you can research it, Google it, so to know more. No rice. I started dieting last November, or yeah, November, on my birthday. Actually, before my birthday, I started dieting. What triggers me? Let's go back to that. What triggers me is that, a simplest thing, I was having a hard time. I always rip my jeans, the front zipper of my jeans. Below that, there is this thread to make the jeans more, I'm not sure, better or something like that. So it always like that, ripped off or snap. The right term is snap. It snapped. Anyway, so that bothers me, and that always happens when I am going to wear a shoe. So that means I'm too fat. And at that time, I was weighing 97 kilos. That's the truth. That's for real. That's the truth. Anyway, there you go. 97, and then I tried to do that keto diet. Although, and anyway, basically you can research what a keto diet is. But I'm not religiously following every step, everything about keto, because I eat some. In keto, so you can eat sugar, like the sugar, the sweet sugar, because it's not natural. Anything starchy, from rice. By the way, we Filipinos, my friends, my subscribers, if there is any, in Philippines, rice is life. We have the saying that rice is life. Or ang kanin ay buhay, or kanin is life, something like that. Kanin is rice in the Philippines. It's called rice. It's kanin. Anyway, so yeah, we love rice. That's our staple food. I'm not sure with other Asian countries though. So I'm just saying that I was never bothered. Even other people will call me fat or whatever. I was never bothered about that. I believe I love myself. I believe in myself. I didn't do religiously the whole ketogenic diet thing, because I still eat turon. This is a dessert here in the Philippines, made of banana and with jackfruit inside it, and then you have to be frying it with sugar. So yes, there's sugar. And then I drink a lot of matcha tea from Starbucks. So the ingredients itself has sugar in it, I think. So I get palpitations at times. So yeah, so I don't drink much coffee, but I drink coffee. I like coffee, but I chose to drink more of green tea or matcha. Not necessarily Starbucks, because it's too, yeah. Starbucks, it's too much. It's too pricey for us in the Philippines. If you drink in the Starbucks, it's too pricey. I guess that's 180 or 160 pesos. So that's too much for us in the Philippines. That's too much. It's too pricey. It's too, no, it's not practical at all. Anyway, going back. So I am now starting a new diet. I'm not sure if it's intermittent fasting. I haven't researched it yet on the net, or I haven't Googled it yet. What's it about? But basically, the concept is you have got to eat in a span of 8 hours. You can eat everything and anything you want in 8 hours, within that time frame, 8 hours. And then after that, you can't eat anything at all except water. But water is okay. So 16 hours will take nothing but water. I'll give you updates for once in a while about how is this diet work for me, or is this diet work for me, and things and stuff like that. Anyway, again, that's intermittent fasting. So I hope this will work for me. I think it's gonna be hard, but I hope I can follow through. The reason also why I switched to another, or I mean rather, I tried this. I'm talking as if I tried this for a long time. No, I'm gonna do this. But anyway, because in ketogenic, going back to ketogenic diet, in ketogenic diet, you get sick, like a keto flu, as they call it, keto flu. Yes, my friends, and it was really awful. Awful feeling. The keto flu. It's awful, awful, awful. As if I don't like being sick and I don't like getting sick. So I feel like I almost died. I really almost died. I took a leave, a sick leave at work at one time and at one point, like a 2 day sick leave, because I was really, 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 really sick. I thought I'm gonna die. So, and then I discovered that it was just natural for a keto, if you're doing a ketogenic diet, so you're gonna get sick, like a keto flu. But anyway, the basic of ketogenic, like I think it's 70 fat. So yeah, anything fat, 20% protein and 10% carbo. So carbo, you said it's no carbo. So no, your carbo you can get it to fruit for to get your carbo, because carbohydrates, we need carbohydrates, my friends. I'm telling you, we need carbohydrates. So vegetables and fruits are the source of carbohydrates, I guess. But anyway, you have to check that out if you wanted to try that. But I'm not recommending it. So yeah, that's the reason why I switch to intermittent fasting, because I don't want to get sick again with that keto flu, because I was already in the plateau. And last December, I'm going back December, before Christmas, I was already on the 80 kilos, and I remain 80 from, can you imagine, I am from 97, I lose lots of kilos, pounds, from 97 to 80, so I was on the plateau. So I need to, it's natural that you have to have a break in a plateau. And by the way, in ketogenic, I'm not sure, for some other people, I don't do cheat day in keto. Keto, no carbohydrates, but definitely I limit myself from taking sugar. Yes. The only sugar that I get is from the Torona, like I said, and the matcha tea, and that's it. But in the coffee, I never... Like, I ordered, like, Americano, so... And then, the double cream or milk, which is high in fat. In Starbucks, there's that. Then, yeah, I cut out the sugar, so no chocolates, no cakes. Sad. Anyway, I am very much looking forward to this new set of dieting thingy, the intermittent fasting. So friends, until next time, please, if you like this video, hit that like button and subscribe if you want, and then also tick the notification bell on the right side. I think it's on the right side, so that you will be informed every time that I post a new vlog. To remain positive all the time, that's what YouTube community is all about. So positivity, that's what the YouTube people will appreciate. So yeah, let's do that. I think it's not hard to be positive. If you don't, you know, spread a little bit of positivity. And yeah, till next time again, thank you, bye.